Hi and welcome. Now, all the virtual machines running in your environment does not hold equal priority, right? Like some hold data which are less important, and there are a few virtual machines which has to be available without any downtime. So what do we do to protect such critical virtual machines? Here is the solution. Protect all your critical VMware virtual machines by replicating them using the Vembu VMware Replication feature. So let me show you the configuration procedure. Now here in this BDR console, click on VM Replication tab you see here and choose the VMware vSphere. Now before we begin with the replication procedure, we need to add the VMware vSphere server. So enter the host IP address and its credentials. Right, so click save. Now this will add the VMware vSphere host, and you can find the added host under the list VMware servers. Alright, now click on VM replication. Now this configuration is quite similar to the usual Vembu backup configuration with few changes. Right here you need to choose the virtual machines you would like to replicate. You can either choose the entire host or only the required virtual machines. Also, you can exclude certain virtual machines or disks which you do not actually want to replicate, right? So now click next. The next option is the application aware processing. It is an optional feature. You can enable this if you have any applications running in your virtual machine. So if you are enabling this, you need to give in your credentials here. Now also you can choose this option to truncate your transaction logs, right? So click next. Now here in this page, choose the frequency you want your virtual machines to be replicated and click next. Now here in this page, give the target server details to which you want your source virtual machine to actually get replicated. Yes, so click next. Now this is an optional configuration, the network mapping. Now this can be helpful if you use different networks in the production site and the disaster recovery site. Right, so click next. Now this again is another option, which is the re-IP rules. Now this can be helpful if the IP addressing scheme in the production site differs from that in the DR site scheme, right? So click next. Finally, review the configuration and you can save the replication. Simple. Now once this is done, the source and the target work in a synchronous motion. All the changes made, the data added or deleted, like every action done in the source virtual machine is replicated to the target. Now this ensures data integrity and high-speed data transfer from production host to the DR host. So this is how simple it is. Like you can simply configure your replication. Right now, just in case, like if your critical production VM faces downtime or is struck with any unfortunate disaster, then all you have to do is, in the BDR server, click on VM replication tab and choose manage replicas. So the replicated VMs will all be listed. So you can click on restore of a particular VM. Yeah, so these are the options available. Now you can perform failover to turn on the replicated VM in the target host, that is a secondary DR host. You can now access your backed up virtual machine in the DR site and continue to work on it. Now talking about failover, it can be either temporary or permanent, and later failback can also be performed to the source production host or to a different host based on requirements. With Vembu VMware replication, you can have a best-in-class RPO and RTO 15 minutes. So yes guys, so this was all about the Vembu's VMware replication feature. And the Vembu support is available 24/7. You can contact us anytime with the phone numbers and the email IDs displayed on the screen. Thanks for watching, and for more such videos, stay tuned.